Říkáme, že by se vyšel Michal Sávě, ne, že nemá Sávě, ale mě je jiný konec, kdo jsou takový. Víte, o čem to, aby tady dáte to, my sami ten sebe, tak se montem sám kontrolu, když jsem tady ale pro. A v té balci vidí, či tady je, jestli by si měli vyskovat, jestli se sadí na mě, ale
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Think of a family that had everything, nobility, power, prestige, and all of a sudden, all of that is taken away, and the harshest condemnations, the harshest tortures, the greatest humiliations fall upon this family. But then at the end of the day, they have and they gain what matters most, heaven, life everlasting. That's pretty much the story of Saint Vivian, or Viviana. She was born of a very noble family. As a matter of fact, her father was prefect of Rome, and her father's name was Flavian. So Flavian, prefect of Rome, he has a wife called Daphrosa, it's a nice name, and he has two daughters, Demetria and Viviana. So what happens is Julian the Apostate rises to power and starts persecuting. And so her father, imagine this, her father, prefect of Rome, Roman nobility, he's arrested and he's branded the mark of a slave on the forehead for refusing to sacrifice to the idols. And then he's going to be humiliated, he's going to be made a slave in the baths of Rome. And then he's going to be exiled and he dies a martyr's death. Meanwhile, his wife Daphrosa, so all of their goods, their estate, their villa is seized. And what happens? She's dragged out of Rome and beheaded. That leaves two beautiful girls behind who are in the age to be married. Of course, they're despoiled of everything. Everything is taken from them. And then a horrible man working under the emperor called Apronianus tried to persuade them, give them honors, give them riches, promise them good marriages if they would only sacrifice to the idols. And of course, they resisted. So Demetria was struck and died a martyr's death. But then Vivian had a greater cross ahead of her. Evil woman, whose name was Rufina, was given the care of Vivian to corrupt her. So it was a woman who knew the way of the world, and her sole mission was to corrupt Vivian. And so first she tried with flattery, with promises, she tried and tried, but Vivian would not budge. And so then eventually all those promises and empty promises, of course, turned into threats, and she would physically beat Saint Vivian. But Vivian never gave up, and this infuriated the new prefect of Rome so much that he had Vivian tied to a pillar and scourged, flogged to death. So with whips, leaded whips. So this girl was flogged to death. And after that, they threw her body to the dogs in Rome, but the dogs wouldn't touch her sacred body. And then her body was taken by a holy man and buried alongside her mother and her sister. So that's the great Roman virgin we commemorate today. Great Roman virgin and martyr. Think of her zeal for Christ, and she had everything. Everything. Their family, nobility, power, riches. And if you could imagine the worst possible scenario, it happened to them. Imagine her faith during these trials. Imagine that faith that kept her faithful to Christ. Faithful to Christ, when it would have been so easy to curse the day she was born, to curse God, she doesn't. Imagine that. May we ask this great saint, this hero of the faith, for a similar faith, a similar commitment to Christ, a similar dedication to Christ, knowing that all that matters in the end is heaven. Lord, give me heaven, get me there by any which way you can. I'll take any way that leads me to heaven. May St. Vivian intercede for us that we may have this commitment to the Savior. As we progress through Advent, let us remember the commitment of Christ. Look at that cross. What will be my commitment to Him? St. Vivian, Virgin and Martyr, pray for us in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Dominus Fabius. Oveus. Tus res patiae in amus, te re benedixit te Deus, et te omni, in seculum seculum. dominus tuus. Sos. Gratias Deus, Domine Deus. Vere de minutibus tu mestre, con et salutare mestre qui sancta et unique gratia sancta. Domine sancte pater, omnipotens et Père de Deus, per Christum Dominum nostrum. Quod perditur omni nuncio de miserator et misericors et fidelis promissis, Deus veritas est sua et vicinis, sanctitas est vicar et vicius, viatus adjuvar et vicius. Tu mergo copias, ut veniat per missuris, sed dies et pulcia et liberationis nostra. In hac commissionum tua rompit et vis gaudius et vicarius. Et ideo cum angelis carpantus, ut tonis et dominationibus, ut per omnime itiac placis et ergius. In un gloria tu et granatus, sine divinitatis. Sancta. Ecce adios Dei, ecce pitorit peccatorum, Domine non sum divinus, et infra sum factum Dei, sed tantum liquor res ad habitum anima Dei. Domine non sum divinus, et infra sum factum Dei, sed tantum liquor res ad habitum anima Dei. Domine non sum divinus, et infra sum factum Dei, sed tantum liquor res ad habitum anima Dei. Thank you. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail, Holy Queen,
Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. Today we cry out that our children are needed. Today we suffer our sorrows, mourning and weeping, and smiling and tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, to the eyes of mercy towards us, and after this, our exile, show up to us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray, God, our refuge and our strength, look down with mercy upon thy people who pray to thee, and for the intercession of the glorious and immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, of thy blessed apostles, Peter, and Paul, and all thy saints, for thou mercifully and graciously give the prayers which are called forth for the conversion of sinners, and for the freedom and exaltation of Holy Mother Church, through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Saint Michael the Archangel, Saint Joseph,
pray
to Christ the King. O Christ Jesus, I acknowledge thee to be the King of the universe. All that hath been made is created for thee. Exercise over me all thy sovereign rights. I hereby renew the promises of my baptism, renouncing Satan and all his words and pomps, and I engage myself to lead henceforth a truly Christian life, and in a special manner bring about the triumph of the rights of God and thy church, so far as lies within me. Divine Heart of Jesus, I offer thee my poor actions to obtain the acknowledgement by every heart of thy sacred kingly power. In such wise may the kingdom of thy peace be firmly established throughout all the earth. Amen. O Jesus, Son of the Living God. O Jesus, Son of the Virgin Mary. O Jesus, King and Center of all.